on today's Prophetic Rewind.
For from this place says the Spirit of God, I will raise up and throughout the earth a generation of Daniels, Davids, Esthers. Come on.
Welcome to Prophetic Rewind, everybody. We are on week two, part two of the Mount Carmel concert that my dad did in 2008. If you haven't seen last week's, go back and watch it, because I shared the story of what made me want to share this concert with you now in the month of May. One of the reasons is that it's 11 years this month since that concert. And before we go into this, I want you to look out for something. Now, you're going to hear my dad prophesy, and you're going to really enjoy this incredible anointed worship, live worship on Mount Carmel, where Elijah called fire from heaven. Just incredible. But there's this beautiful moment that happens, and it's between my brother Caleb and my dad. And in the middle of worship, and as my dad's prophesying, my brother had a banjo and a bow, and he started playing a very unusual sound in the middle of that, and you'll hear it, and you'll see my dad's response, because, you know, my dad really responded to the guidance of the Spirit and where God was taking him. So he was very open, and a lot of what he did flowed with the Spirit and where God was taking him, and wasn't too structured and routine. It was really a flow, and you'll see that happen between my brother and my father, which is such a beautiful thing. For me to see my dad and my brother together like that is just really awesome, especially now. But you'll notice my dad's response, because he stops everybody and allows my brother to play that sound, and then it just shifts everything in a new direction, and it's so beautiful. So be looking out for that now as you watch this. But again, won't waste any of your time. Let's go back and watch Mount Carmel 2008, the concert with my dad. This is part two.
Spirit.
run too deep. Life is calling unto life. I will give visions. For they have spoken so much in these end days and end times of tribulation, of execution. But my God tells me, in the presence of the great cloud of witnesses tonight, there are those who have obtained a testimony that watch. Elijah said, is there somebody that can stand in the presence of the Baals and bring fire? Daniel watches and says, is there somebody that can stand before a king, a Babylonian king, and tell him his dream? David stands and watches and says to you, from these great battlefields, is there somebody with one stone that can bring down a principality? That stone, Christ Jesus. Moses stands in the great cloud of witnesses and speaks to this people in this day through the Holy Spirit. These are the words he says. Is there somebody that can stand before the Pharaoh and make declarations? Let these people go. Is there somebody that can strike a rock and bring water from it? This is Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They're watching. Is there someone that can find a fourth man in the fire? For from this place, says the Spirit of God, I will raise up, and throughout the earth, a generation of Daniels, Davids, Esthers. Come on. Child, do you have a grandchild to give to the Lord? Is there Samuel in your house? God said, from this place and throughout the nations of the earth, tonight I take the stones, I take my church, and I raise up the Samuels, Davids, Daniels, Ruths, Esthers, Marys, Moses. I raise them up. And once again, in Christ, they shall slay giants. In Christ, they shall bring victory to nations. I will raise up Josephs, who will prophesy to kings of the East. Middle East, you have no choice. I have selected you, set you on side for my fire and for my price, says the Lord of hosts. Come on. Come on. An interpretation of what took place Joseph. Thank you. Yeshua, 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 Yeshua. Mighty One of Israel is waiting, watching over you, waiting for your praise. Mighty One of Israel, standing over you, oh, and is watching, watching over you. Standing in this place and wants you to reach inside of him, touch him, touch him, Father, we thank you today as we stand on a territory that was once possessed by the filth, the blood, the urine of what they call the prophets of Baal. And a man stood, Lord, made a declaration to the people, said these words: gather together. And they began to build an altar together. Took 12 stones, built an altar. And then he said, God, as we take these that represent every expression that there is in Israel, send us fire. Send us rain. Today, Lord, we pray for the spiritual fire. As a people, we stand. We do not want to be entertained. We pray. We pray from the ground of the soil of Israel. We pray, send us the fire. Send us the rain. Pray, everybody, pray. Because that's what we came here to do. Pray together. Pray. I want to hear you pray. Yes. Yes. That's what he wants to hear. On this soil, we pray again. Return to us. Not with a portion that Elijah had, but with a double portion, with a triple portion. Pray, people, pray, people, pray, people, pray. Pray. Tonight, I will honor this territory. As you pray tonight, I will honor this entire territory and send throughout the earth the fire that I once brought upon the altar. I will send once again the fire that what is necessary to destroy the destroyer. And to bring life to your families. Pray! Pray! Come on! Come on! As you pray, God says, fire shall come and consume the enemies that have stopped your children, that have stopped your business, that have stopped your ministry. Pray as loud as you can.
Wow, wasn't that incredible? Wasn't that beautiful? Pray, pray, pray. That is so anointed. And when I sat and watched this concert again, I saw all new things. And so I know some of you may have seen it before. Probably a lot of you haven't. So I know it blessed you. And the number one thing for me, the most important thing for me, is that these prophetic rewinds, these looks into the past, are to bless you now. So it's very important to me about what I release and when. And this is something that I pray about, and I'm obedient to God's direction in this. And so God directed me to share this concert with you, because it isn't just about music. It isn't even just about worship. It's about what God was saying at this concert 11 years ago. And this month marks 11 years. And so you're gonna see part three next week, and it's very, very important that you watch all three parts. And I've sectioned it into three parts so that you can look at each section and really absorb what God was doing and saying through my dad and the team there on Mount Carmel 11 years ago. And also the fact that he took me there on the date, and I didn't even realize it till I was standing on Mount Carmel. And that really shows you just how incredible God is. You know, he knows the end from the beginning, and it's such a beautiful thing, those little moments. And so I feel so honored to be able to share this with you. And for all of you who give to and support Prophetic Rewind and what I'm doing with the legacy of my dad, this is only one of the many things that I'm doing. And so your support, it's not just helping me to do all of these things that God's shown me to do. It's also for you and that sacrifice. And so make a declaration today as you're giving to Prophetic Rewind, to the legacy of my dad. You'll be able to see all the different ways that you can sow. And you're sowing not only into what I'm doing and what we're doing here at the House of Destiny Network and the future, but you're also sowing into that prophetic word that he gave then that is applicable now. So there's so many layers to this, and it's just so beautiful. And so as you are obedient, as I am obedient in giving the offering, and you know Mount Carmel, what happened there is what it happened at an altar. You know, it was at an altar that the battle between the prophets of Baal and Elijah, that battle went on right there at Mount Carmel, and it's so incredible. And so I think it's so fitting that we come to the altar and give an offering into that prophetic word and that prophetic moment. And we all know that reaps a prophet's reward, and that is such a sacred and beautiful, beautiful thing. And so thank you so much for joining me again. Next week will be the final part of the Mount Carmel concert, part 3. And so you don't want to miss it. And if you haven't seen part 1, I encourage you to go back and listen to it and watch it too, because it's just incredible and beautiful all the way through. So I love you all, and we'll see you next week.